And I've always done what I want anyway. She can't really tell me otherwise. I'm a bit like that.
One thing she never let me do that I was very upset about, I remember watching Grease and wanting a pair of shiny trousers and a pair of high heels, just like Olivia Newton-John, and she wouldn't let me do it, so that's the only thing I wasn't allowed to do. So I wore it in our last video.
With me. We've got a very good, strong relationship. She's a very strong woman as well, you know, from whenever I can remember, she was always strong in what she wanted to do. I think the most rebellious stage I was at was maybe coming in like 10 minutes late just to see what she'd think.
I don't like it.
Blow.
Now up here. Mum, here.
Put it that pillar in, lovely night.
Yeah, as soon as we finish.
Do lots more ironing and washing, and she comes in with her bag after, you know, being away and drops it on the floor and I empty it out. And get it packed again ready for the next thing that she has to do. And there's lots more telephone calls.
And letters and
fans at the door and people wanting autographs. And yeah, it's really, really busy now.
But we haven't changed, have we?
No, we're the same. We're the same.
We'd be the same. We still watch EastEnders and eat chocolate Rolos.
Yeah.
And McDonald's. You don't really take home with you, oh, I've sold such and such and such and many of songs and I did this today and I'm, you know, you don't really take that home with you at all. You
just... No, she just walks through the door and it's like Emma again and we're just back, you know, to normal. What's on telly tonight? What's for dinner? What are we doing? You know, and it's
what's
just...
What's for dinner?
Yeah, what's the takeaway?
Microwave dinner.
What would you like to eat? And we just run through these takeaways.
We've got a whole big pile of, of takeaway numbers.
Yeah. People normally throw them away, you know, when they get a leaflet through the door for some sort
we
of takeaway.
We get all excited about it.
Great.
A new one.
I mean, when she was about 18 months old, we have a carnival in Finchley, a big carnival, and they have a big football pitch which is, you know, cornered off. And we couldn't get a seat, so we were sitting on the grass. And Emma had just creeped through and gone underneath the ropes. And everybody was just watching this brass band going round and da-da-da-da, this big band comes in. And I was like, I could hear, and then this clapping like this. And we stood up and I was like, well, where's Emma? And Emma was standing on the pitch. Dancing and clapping her hands, and she literally got the whole arena. Everybody was clapping.
That was my first show, man.
Each go! Just go. Ray,
sit down now.
This is the bit where you've got to look mean. Ready? So everybody put one here, one here. Double block. One, two, three, I remember, you know, when I used to be a child model, I just remember it really being good fun, knitting things and knitting patterns and things like that. And it, only in those days, it used to be that you had to stand and have your hand in your pocket properly, and, you know, you were like a statue. But when Emma went into it, they wanted more fun things.
Brushing helps you fight the plaque, for gum health it does excel. Take good care of your gums, brush with Mentadent gel.
I said, look, I've got a four-year-old going on five who is dancing around all over the place, and I know you start from 8 years, but, you know, can I just bring her along and, you know, see how she gets on?
I remember that day.
Do you remember that?
I loved it. It was the best thing. You know, obviously, because when you're in your front room and you're like, Mum, there's chairs in the way, I can't do my dancing. And then I had this big hall and there was all kids, and it was brilliant. I loved it.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, Cheryl loved her. And actually, Emma was her first pupil to get a blue ribbon, which is like the highest that you can get, so...
Everybody's doing a brand new dance now.
Your phone calls to your mother at every situation.
We are now entering the record company, Mum.
You're taking the mic?
Yeah.
Are you?
Yeah. That's good, though. Her mum has lived everything we've lived.
She has, hasn't she?
And her mum and my mum are on the phone all the time, aren't they?
Yeah.
When
Gaffing.
Oh, did you see Victoria and Emma?
Yeah. Is anyone seeing Vic?
No.
No, what's in it? What?
It's a really hideous picture of us at Heathrow Airport.
Oh no!
And you know, in the morning when you don't pull on your makeup, you just put a bit onto the highlight and roll it up.
Just, I've got a bit of a break, so I thought I'd phone and say hi. Okay, love you loads. Love you. Bye. 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 Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Love you. Love you.
Bye. Bye.
Hiya.
Bye, Mum.
Like, we are we're really like flatmates. That's what it is. We're like flatmates. She gives me a lot of my own space. You know, I have my own room and things like that. And so we are more like flatmates. If I have friends around, I tell her to get out. If she wants, you know, a night in on her own, then I'll go out. I mean, she does really, she washes my clothes, gets them ready, and then I pick what I want to take, you know. So she just makes sure that I'm not running around too hectic and I'm not too stressed, which is brilliant.
You tend to go home and really kind of, you know, let it all
they
out. I really take it out on my mum, and my mum does everything for me.
You go, yes, but Mum, you are my mother. You should know.
You should understand.
You are my mother. You should have got me some Muller Lights and some Satsumas when I come home at night. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, they do take a lot, don't
yeah,
they?
Definitely.
Mom, a mother is for life, not just for Christmas.
Actually, you know, we were talking about my mother earlier. There is something wrong with her. She's rubbish at cooking. She is absolutely... crap.
World's worst.
Yeah. The worst cook in the world.
Yeah, but she can't be good at everything. She's got to have some faults, hasn't she? Do you know what I mean?
There it is, cooking.
Mum's got auburn hair. She's got a big nose.
She
has. My mum has. She's quite sweet and cuddly.
She's a babe.
She's lovely. I think that's the best way to be. Really, really open. I mean, you're like that with
I'm
your mum.
I'm very open with Mum, but I don't actually talk to her about sex. I did when I needed to, like,
you know,
when I
wanted to, though.
Yeah, when I needed advice, I did, but I don't actually tell her the ins and outs of sex.
Guess what we did last night, Mum? It's about this girl later, this Mum. Listen to what happened last night.
Yeah, Mum, you want to try this out?
Try this one. It's shock 'em.